Okay. My name is Evan Toy, and I'm a senior from Mount Michael. This final is about existentialism. As a child, I am fascinated with truth. Not only I find this way, centuries setting up in the room. I will take a look, squeeze, and with the green little grip off my hand, imagining wonderland in fairy tales, showing myself in the darkness. But those times were evanescent. The major satisfaction that makes me stress on reality lives inside me. Have they drifted away like the autumn wind, as hidden, as distant, as free on the edge of the sea? Homework, games, college apps, sports, social media. For years, I got tired of all this, everything to a style, routine, repetitive boring. It is like a sail out to the sea. First, I was fascinated with the vast ocean, magnificent ships, seagulls, blue skies. But after hours and hours, the blue sky merges with the blue sea and nothing over the horizon, bearing no difference to a piece of cellulose gray wall. Waves and ripples have not a power, it's the only source of stimulation. It serves as an eternal cause of personal preservation, but now it only agitates me, only urges me to demand more. I walk to the edge of the boat. My wings tore away my skin. I feel the mask that I feel myself. I pulled me to the other side of the universe, shed me out of my torso. The sea is like an abyss. It drags my massive soul with overwhelming force towards a room of emptiness. Knowing there's no meaning to resist, I fall and embrace the darkness. What if not become enlightened by enjoying imagining figures of light that are making the darkness conscious? It does not feel like tired within dreams, but like home. It's a feeling after working all day long and seeing my given body into a great old cat. The sea has a special rhythm. It substitutes my heartbeat, grows into my long-gone body, vibrates in congruence with my veins and arteries. I become one with the darkness, the origin of my existence. With my new culture, I stand up on top of earth, breathing clouds and thunder as the moon strikes past my head. Looking down, the earth is covered in steel, blue, white, green. From space, it looks the same as it was a billion years ago. If humanity isn't able to change the appearance of Earth, how can I make a difference? I cannot. But this doesn't matter. Looking across the grave of sight, dotted against the eternal darkness, I gave a flash my eye. I think, therefore I am.